Shalom, good evening. People ask me to give some introduction of Kabbalah, some basic thing in Kabbalah, so people will be able to understand me more easy. Kabbalah really is a teaching of prophecy. What we have left from the teaching of prophecy as a, how you say, schema, how, as a
scheme,
like a formula of all the teaching of Kabbalah. So what we have left, Kabbalah, of course, teaching, learning of prophecy was a life experience. It was not a technical teaching. But the live experience of how to become prophet, we don't teach it anymore so much in Judaism. There are people that learn to do meditation, etc. It's like more practical teaching, but to learn Kabbalah, it means to learn the formula of this teaching of prophecy. It means how the soul is built, how the world, spiritual world, are built. Construction, the secret of the name of Yud Kei Vav Kei. What the name Yud Kei Vav Kei mean?
The name of God.
The name of God. Special name Yud Kei Vav Kei, what it
means.
All right, so
what
this is the teaching of Kabbalah. Kabbalah came from the word makbilot, what it means, parallel. This verb, lekabel, to receive, don't exist in the five book of Torah, in this mean of to receive. It is not written this word to receive in
that
the five book of Torah. This root appear only in the sense of parallel, makbilot alulaot. In the building of Mishkan, the lulaot was the loops was parallel. Right? This the only place in the book of Torah that this root of the word lekabel, Kabbalah, appear. Right? So it's the most important thing when we learn Kabbalah. It not mean that we learn to receive. It means that we learn to receive too, but it's not the thing. We learn to parallel thing.
Awesome.
This is the main thing in Kabbalah, to learn how to parallel thing.
Okay.
If we parallel thing in a good way, of course we can connect ourselves to something above us that is parallel. And receive from it. But all the idea is a parallel. This is the main concept in Kabbalah. It's not to receive, it's parallel. This is what we do in Kabbalah. This is what we learn to do. We parallel this to this, we parallel this to this, parallel all the time, parallel thing.
Concepts and
we
words.
Parallel concept to the name of Yud Kei Vav Kei. All right, so the name of Yud Kei Vav Kei have to do with the 10 Sefirot. So
it's a template of creation.
Yeah, so there are four letters, so we can parallel, every time we have four concepts, we can parallel them to the four letters of Yud Kei Vav Kei. When we have five concepts, we can parallel them to Yud Kei Vav Kei with the crown.
The
with,
root.
With the Kutso Shel Yud.
The root of reality.
Okay, so when we have six things, we can parallel only to the letter Vav of the name of God, that is the sixth attribute of the heart. If we have seven things, it will include the kingdom too, the
Malchut.
The Malchut. All right, so we parallel things. This is the main thing of learning Kabbalah,
mm-hmm.
How to parallel anything we learn to the name of God.
You can write the name of God on the table so people can see what you're talking about?
Well, we don't write the name of God on the table because we are not allowed to write.
Yeah, but you don't have to write
it
in such a way.
I write number instead of the four letters.
Okay.
10 is a Yud, 5 is a Hey, 6 is a vav, and 5 is another time hey. Mm-hmm. It's expressions that appear many times in the Bible, from the world to the world, min haolam v'ad haolam. This word, 5, always have to do with a word, and this have to do with a word. This it's like the revealed world, it's like the spiritual world.
World.
World. Olam.
Olam.
Min haolam v'ad haolam. Okay. Right? This is...
Interesting.
Tzimtzum, restriction.
Restriction.
Or I used to say construction.
Constriction, but it's actually restriction. But
maybe the word restriction is more correct. Tzimtzum, because this tzimtzum is a yud, it's a point. This is a point of the letter yud. It's like God, before the creation of the world, make all his light, infinite light, disappear to leave an empty place to create the world in this empty place. So this empty place is a point of yud. Right?
It's like the beginning of this universe, of this creation.
The beginning of everything is a bereshit. It's what we call in the tenth sirot, it's what we call wisdom. Wisdom, chokhmah, is the beginning of any self-consciousness. Any self-consciousness starts with wisdom.
That is just under the crown, under the root, wisdom.
The crown is above consciousness. I am not aware of the crown. It's like subconsciousness or above consciousness. The yud is when I have a new idea. It appears like a point, like a flesh, like a barak. How you say barak? A light man. Before the rain is a light.
Lightning.
Lightning is called barak. All right, so the chokhmah called barak ha-mavrik. It's a flesh. I have a new idea.
It's a bright in light man.
Right, so this is the yud of the name of God. After...
Bright lightning.
After, it's pashtut. We have to expand this idea.
Continuation.
No, no continuation. It pashtut.
It pashtut.
It pashtut. It's like this point.
Expansion.
Expansion. It's like the point of the yud in the letter. It becomes three line in three dimension. What represents the letter he? The letter he. One dimension. Second dimension and third dimension to expand the point to three dimensions. This is one of the ideas.
So like three axes.
One of the ideas of the letter He,
it means
that we reveal many details out from this point. We reveal all the details that in the point are hiding. They are there, but they are not revealed.
They are potential.
All right?
Inside
so the wisdom is like a potential, and you have to be revealed. It's like a seed.
To become manifested.
It's like a seed. This is like a seed. Now the mother, this is the mother. The mother takes the seed and makes from the seed a big baby. Mm-hmm. All right? So this is like the Torah writing. And this is like the oral Torah, what our sages expand the Torah with infinite of books. All right?
Explain how to apply the...
Explain to... everything that has to be explained in Kabbalah, in Pshat, how to do the commandment, what mean any word, all the gematriot, everything that you can learn.
How to do it.
All right, so just the written letter that was appearing in the Torah, it's like a seed, it's like a DNA.
It's what to do, and the next one is how to do.
Yeah, you can explain it this way too. All right, so this is expand, it pashtut.
Expansion.
Now this is amshacha. How you say it?
This is continuation.
Continuation. This is a vav, it means it's a vector of energy.
Sometimes you say it's a double vav, actually.
Yeah, okay. And again it pashtut.
This is also like Zerampin.
Again.
The Vav.
Yudke Vavke is Tzimtzum, it pashtut, Amshacha, it pashtut. It's like, this is like my thought. It's not revealed word, but it's a word.
World?
It's a world, my thought, what I think.
Olam.
Alright? Everything what I think, it's a world. But it's not a revealed world.
It's a potential.
Now, this world has to be revealed here, in a reveal. In a reveal.
Manifest.
As something revealed. This is a speech. What everything I think, through the voice, this is like the voice. Now it become 22 letters.
This is the voice, like the above is the voice.
Yeah, this is 22 letters. This is the attribute of the heart, the voice. It's
heart.
What I think pass through the heart.
Heart.
Yeah.
Okay.
For the emotions.
Emotions, the feelings.
All right.
Okay.
And here it become words.
Words.
Word. It's a reveal word.
World or words?
Olam.
Olam. World.
World.
Okay.
This is a revealed world, this is a hiding world. This is like Olam Abba.
Okay.
This is a world to come. This world. Alright? This is generally what it means, Yudke Vavke. This like, here is the world of angel. This is the word to come, it's angel, that it's like the
they make
the connection between the reveal reality and the hiding reality. Alright?
Mm-hmm. So this is actually parallel with Olam Atzilut and Bria Yetzira Asiya.
This is parallel to Olam Atzilut, Bria Yetzira Asiya. This is the world of mental, this is the world of emotion, and this is the world of action. A few words about this four words. Atzilut, Bria, Yetzira, Asiya. When we talk about the 10th Sefirot and the name of God, Yudke Vavke, this is one of the million parallels we have to the name of Yudke Vavke. It's a parallel. Alright? It's not. When we talk about the 10th Sefirot, usually we talk about Olam Atzilut. That is, all the 10th Sefirot are here. Now, it is written in the Zohar that Abba Mekanen Ba'atzilut. It means the wisdom. Where is the place of the wisdom? In all Olam Atzilut. And where is the place of the Bina? Where is the nest? Mekanen, it means put her nest, make it as her nest. Like a bird.
Keken is a nest.
A nest. Mekanen, it means live there, in this nest. Right, so the mother, her place, mekanenet, in the Olam of Boya. And what you call the midot, the iranpin, mekanen in Olam Yetzira, the world of angel, and the malku, the kingdom of God, mekanen in Olam Asiya. All right, so we can say that this corresponds to just Olam Atzilut. Usually, this is what we talk about when we talk about the name of God, about the 10th Sefirot, about what we parallel think. We talk about Olam Atzilut. Olam Atzilut has his crown, his private crown. The private crown of Olam Atzilut has two faces. We mentioned the concept of the faces before. This is
Partsufim.
This is father, this is mother, this is Zeranpin, and this is Nukva de Zeranpin.
It's like Malchut, actually.
Malchut, it's not the name of a face.
Yes, but it's kind of equivalent, it's parallel.
Yes, but now I say the name of the face.
Mm-hmm.
The name of the face is not Malchut, is the Nukva, the female of the Ranpin. All right, the general name of the face.
Mm-hmm.
It's more private name of the face. Maybe we'll talk about this later. But
Nukva is like a female.
Yes, is the female of the Ranpin. This father, this mother, this the Ranpin.
Like male aspect and female.
And
aspect.
This is the Nukva, the Ranpin. Above this you have Ari Ranpin. And above Ari Ranpin you have Atik Yomin. Now,
inside the crown.
Now, when we talk about Yudke Vavke as these four concepts, is more general, wide. How you say it, Pashtut? It's more wide understanding of the name, expanding point of view. So then, the general crown of the general word of the world, not the private crown of Olam Atzilut. The private crown of any Olam called Ari Ranpin Atik Yomin. But if I talk about this as a big Yud Kevavke that contains four words, so the general crown of this called Adam Kadmon. You said?
The primordial man.
All right, so this by the way. Here, there are 10 spheres. How there are 10 spheres?
Mm-hmm.
One is a crown, two is a wisdom, is Keter,
above,
subconsciousness, up, above consciousness,
mm-hmm.
beginning of consciousness, the expand of the consciousness, the continuation through the attribute of the heart. It's like the children that born.
That actually contains six
here spherot. We have the letter Vav that equals six. Here we have six spherot, six attributes of the heart.
Inside.
And here we have the kingdom, the Malchut.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So, people will ask, what is the root of all this in the Bible? They want to be biblical, all right? So, this is Chochmah, and this is Bina,
mm-hmm.
and between them, the connection between them is called Dat.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you count Dat as one of the ten. This is six, this is one, this is one, and this is one. All right, we have only nine here. Chochmah is one. Bina is second.
Mm-hmm.
Six is a Vav, and the kingdom is another one. We have only nine.
Mm-hmm.
So where is the next one? It can be the crown, the Keter, or it can be the Dat,
right,
the knowledge. Knowledge, it means connection in Hebrew.
Mm-hmm.
It means the connection between mother and father. We call this mother and father. Or the connection between all the mental, all the brain, to the heart.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Both. There are two many kind of connection.
Mm-hmm.
This is the 10th sefirot that we talk about this in Kabbalah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now, what is the root of this 10 sefirot in the Bible? In many places in the Bible appears the concept of the brain, of the mental, what is called Chochmah, Bina, Dat. Wisdom, understanding, and knowledge. Understanding, it's like Bina, it's from the word Livnot, to build. It takes a point and make a whole building from it.
Bina is also intelligence.
Yes. Bina is from the word Lavin, but Lavin, to understand, came from the word Livnot, to build. Binyan, building. All right, this is a mother, she's going to build a building, a baby. All right. She's going to build a baby of what? When I understand something, I say, wow. Right? This is the attribute of the born. It palut. Wow. How great is God?
Excitement.
Excitement, all right? So this is the baby that born. Love, fear, etc. This is excitement. Why, how is it born? Well, I say Shema Israel, I meditate how God is great, God that build the star and this and the angel, etc.
All the universe,
all right, so I think about this, about how fantastic is the Torah, and when I understood something about how great is God, about his wisdom, I say, wow, this wow is becomes the attribute of the heart.
Understanding.
The love? No.
That is understanding.
No.
So
what is below the
underneath,
that?
Underneath, okay.
So alright, what?
Underneath. Okay.
The attribute of the heart.
Okay.
What is love and fear? Mm-hmm. I fear God. Why? It's so great that what I'm doing here, I'm like a chomun ketem. It's a white page, and I'm a
spot,
dark point.
Spot,
that what I'm doing here in
the
godliness.
Spot on a white page.
Yeah, well, you know. So it makes me fear,
fearful.
And I don't want to be there. My existence, it's like in benigud, in the. How you say?
In opposition
to the reality of God. What I'm doing here, I want to vanish, to disappear. This is called the fear of God.
Yirat Shamayim.
Yirat Hashem. All right? In another way, is the love of God, that I want to get close, I want to hug. All right? So it's two opposite
feeling
that cause the understood of the greatness of God, what is the right and the left. Alright? And this feeling become wings. This is what you call the wings. The spiritual way to fly. If we don't have two wings, we cannot fly anywhere. What is the love and the fear of God? Alright, so it is... For example, in the book of Shemot, in the Torah himself, when they are going to put Bezalel to build the Mishkan, so God said, I feel him, Ruach Elokim, Spirit of God, Bechokhma, in wisdom, uvitvuna. Tvuna is another form of Bina. Uvedat. Alright, so is a chokhma bina dat that appear in the book of Exodus?
Exodus.
Alright, so it's something that appear this concept of the mental in many places in the Torah. Alright, so this is something that corresponds to each one of us. All the concept of Kabbalah is
within us.
Is we have to do with each one of us. We have to understand what is in our soul. It's not something there. It's not that God is a big animal and I am a small animal, and because he's a big animal, so I better do what he do, and this is all the story.
And not Bilbado, he's within us, and we are.
We have to learn godliness through our flesh. Mipsari echze eloka. From my flesh,
our experience here.
I will experience God. Alright, so God is part of us. And to learn God, it means to learn ourselves. To learn Kabbalah, it means to learn our soul.
Kabbalah is a wisdom, is a science.
Of course. Alright?
It's not a religion.
Alright, so after this, you have the six attributes of the heart.
Heart.
We call them
מידות הלב?
כן. וכל זה חסד, גבורה, תפארת, נצח, הוד, יסוד. This is a vav of the name of God. It's free and free. Always right, left, middle, right, left, and middle. This is like the two hands and the body. This is like the two legs and the sphere of Yesod and the breath.